to the vlog. I'm just gonna do a little home vlog today. I don't really have anything planned. We're just gonna be hanging out here at home and just doing mom things. We might put some more ornaments on the tree or something, I'm not sure. But I woke up with the worst headache today. Actually, I had a headache all day yesterday. Went to sleep with it, woke up with it. Don't know if it's just from pregnancy or what, but we got hit with a nasty stomach bug last week, and ever since, my body is just taking forever to recover. Just being pregnant, nursing, taking care of a toddler, I feel like I'm so depleted of vitamins and minerals, and that could be why I have a headache. But anyways, welcome to the vlog. This video is sponsored today. I am working with babymust, which they have a little, they have a couple products, but the product that I specifically want to talk about is their, is their hip carrier. I'm actually about to go put it on, so I'll show you guys once I'm cooking breakfast and stuff, but I really love it. Especially, it has come in handy being pregnant. We've used it so much. We used it a lot in the move because he didn't want to be put down, of course. I feel like they can tell when you have a big life change, and like when I was trying to pack and put things away and unpack and clean, that boy wanted to be attached to me quite literally at the hip, and this thing makes it just so easy to pick him up, put him down, because you know they change their mind every 2 seconds. It's been amazing for like grocery store runs and things like that, so I'll show you once I put it on because we're going to start cooking breakfast and stuff. But he's kind of happily playing right now, which is a little bit rare, like just first thing in the morning, so I think I'm going to try to take advantage of that and clean up a little bit because we had Friendsgiving last night, so the kitchen is still like a little bit of a mess because I was just way too tired to take care of it last night. I actually am doing like a little oven breakfast today, so we'll just do this while breakfast is cooking and maybe we can clean a little bit. So I'm going to show you how I get this all set up. This is the product I was talking about. This is the babymust hip carrier, and like I will admit I have seen ads for these and I just was always like, really? Like, why can't you just put them on your hip? And then I got this and I realized why it makes such a difference to not just put them on your hip. So the thing about this is you want to make sure you put it on way tighter than what you think you need to, because once you add your baby, it kind of like pulls down on it a bit, and you want to make sure they're like nice and on you. So it's a little bit like you just want to make sure you're set, but there's like a little bottle holder here, so if I really wanted to, I could bring his sippy cup hands-free. I have this bag, this whole pouch right here. I have wipes, a diaper, a passy, and some snacks for him. Whoa! Now, it's not like technically supposed to be hands-free because you still want to be safe, but like for the most part, he is not going anywhere. I'm not 100% sure what like kind of plate is inside of this. It's cushioned, but whatever plate is holding him up feels like very, very sturdy. And honestly, this is so much nicer for my back being pregnant. Like this feels so comfortable to me. Sits right above my hips. There's pockets, there's storage, there's an extra strap to like pull yourself even tighter. He's not going anywhere and he kind of loves it. I wore this the whole time that I went on a solo Target trip with him because he didn't want to sit in the cart. And it was honestly so enjoyable for both of us because usually if I'm like having him on my hip without this carrier, he's kind of squirming, wants to get down. I honestly think this is more comfortable for him. And it's just so nice that I still have a little bit of more, like, more freedom. That's a microwave. And my arm does not get tired from, like, death gripping onto him. I don't have to keep switching sides. You can put it in the front. You can put it on the other side. Seriously, so nice. This pocket makes it so handy because you could also just go without your purse. I can put my keys, my wallet, gum, chapstick, everything in here. It's on major deal right now on Amazon. It's 59% off. I will put a link in my description box for you guys to shop. You can use code CELEST20 to get 20% off plus a 20% coupon on Amazon. I'll put the link in the description box for you guys to shop. But it comes in camo, gray, leopard, olive green, and black. Like, they have some cute options. I got black just because I wanted Austin to be able to feel like he could wear it whenever. But it is a lifesaver. especially for those just like quick in and out errands that you have to run. Like yesterday we had to go to the post office and to Target, and with a kid you're just getting them in and out of the car seat, in and out of the cart. Well, this one, it's off the car seat onto my hip, back into the car seat. So easy. I feel like it's less annoying for them. Thank you again, Baby Must, for sponsoring today's video. Belly smiling. Like I said, I'll have a link in the description box with my code for you guys to save. But we gotta eat breakfast and make coffee, and maybe that coffee will help this headache go away. We're just having these Alexa paws. We're having these croissant rolls that I rolled up some ham and cheese in just because it sounded easy and yummy, and my little man is yelling at me. He's yelling at me. Okay, so you can have a ham and cheese croissant. You're gonna have yogurt with it? Okay, we gotta get a spoon. Delicious breakfast. You gotta be patient, it's hot. Hey, don't say no to mama. Okay. This is little man's breakfast. And we are actually gonna eat in the dining room this morning. I feel like that literally never happens, but it's like officially set up so we can. Yeah, hold on. There is carpet in our dining room still. That is a project for another time. Flooring right now is just like outrageously expensive, and honestly, we just be on a budget right now, you know what I mean? We just bought a house, so it's not like, I don't know. So all that to say, I lay down this leather, like extra fabric from when I made the cushions for our breakfast nook at our last house underneath his high chair to kind of hopefully protect the carpet. But to be honest, he's not really in much of a throwing food phase anymore. Can usually just gauge by how he's acting if he's gonna be done soon, and get him down before the throwing happens, because that's usually when it starts happening. Okay. Bad to sneeze. Oh, excuse me. Okay, so you have yogurt, blackberries, and ham and cheese croissants. Do you want me to do it? Basement. I'm gonna do some laundry. Belle is just playing with some toys. I have all my toys for toy rotations down here, so whenever we come down here, it's kind of nice because I bring him down here obviously while I do the laundry, and he has stuff that he can play with down here while I get this done. But I'm trying out this new laundry detergent because I finally ran out of my Melaleuca detergent, And this is supposed to be 64 loads in this tiny bottle. I use this brand for dishwasher detergent. It's called Better. That's a washer and dryer. Sorry if you can't hear me very well. The dryer is running. Four times concentrated, use less, do more. And it's sulfate-free, naturally. Let's see, I don't think it has fragrance in it. It has lavender oil, soap bark, grapefruit, bergamot. As far as I know, these ingredients are really good, but this is just like a close to non-toxic, low-toxic laundry soap that I could find. No bleach, no synthetic fragrances, no brighteners, no SLS or SLES, and it's plant-based. So, anyways, how much do I use? A half a cap? It says for regular loads, turn on the machine and pour half a cap. Alrighty. I'm so backed up on laundry, you guys do not even want to see the pile that is behind me. Ooh, this smells really good. Is Beanie being funny? He's so funny. Later, we took a walk outside. It was so beautiful. It's like 40 degrees and sunny here, and it's the winter already for us, basically. What is my hair doing? I washed my hair last night, so it's just been sitting weird all day, but we took a walk, and he really enjoyed that. Came home, I nursed him for a little bit. I tried to play with him, but he just wasn't having it, so I put him down early for his nap. Usually he was, before the time change, going down at 12:30, and now I put him down at like 11:30, which I like that anyways, because he has an earlier bedtime that way. But I've wasted a lot of time on my phone, so I was watching those TikToks where they play the song Back to Life by Bethel, and the bridge is, "The enemy thought he had me, but Jesus said you are mine." And it's so hype, and people have been sharing like salvation, like before and after being saved, pictures and videos, and like playing that song on TikTok, and they make me cry. I love watching them, and I was just like watching a bunch of those and scrolling on my phone. But I made lunch, just a little microwave Amy's meal. I think they're organic, but that brand has like amazing TV dinners. Like, I'm not a fan of TV dinners, but like convenience, and if it's good and healthy and yummy, I will eat it. So I'm eating one of those, and I think I'm gonna try to sit and spend some time with the Lord in my bed, my cozy little room. And then we'll get up and do some cleaning. I have some home projects that I honestly could do today if I get a chance during this nap, but I'm not sure how long this nap will be, so I'm gonna try to utilize my time. I also kind of would love to just sit and read on my Kindle and just relax, but we'll see. Finished my lunch. I have been really loving prayer journaling again, because to be quite honest, I just have completely fallen out of routine with that, and like I feel like I just do not have the mental capacity to keep it all up in my head, like just pray, you know, mentally. I mean, I say little prayers throughout the day obviously, but just doing it in my head alone, I feel like I have a hard time kind of, you know, putting all my thoughts together well and not getting distracted. take my trash downstairs, clean up the kitchen, see where we're at as far as like time goes. Might make another coffee too. It's kind of sounding good. But yeah, like the house just overall needs like a good tidy, and I don't know, I can stick on like a YouTube video or something and kind of enjoy some me time while I get that cleaned up. The house projects that I would like to do today, I would really love to stain our fireplace mantle that Austin built. He did such a wonderful job. He made this mantle. I'm like, it just looks so beautiful, but I do have a wood stain for it, so I would love to stain that. We also have this little round like breakfast table that we sanded off the paint so that I can stain it because it was painted black, and I just love warmer tones and warmer colors, as you guys know. So let's clean first, see how much time I have left after that. But it's such a beautiful like fall looking day outside. For some reason on camera it just never picks up well. Like, it's actually colorful and pretty out there, but it just doesn't look like it. But wow, it's so great. What's not great is this. So let's take care of it. Get the kitchen and the dining room cleaned up, and now I think I'm gonna take the mantle down. I have to take all my decor off, and I'm gonna take it down and take it out to our little sunroom and stain it, because I don't think that will take very long, and he honestly should be waking up any minute. He's taken such a great nap. He must have been so sleepy, and I'm like so thankful because I put him down early, so I thought he would wake up a lot earlier. But first coat, this is in the sun. It does not look as dark as I was hoping, so I think I'll have to do multiple coats, but I still like the fact that it looks more like wood and not just unfinished wood. So I'm gonna let this dry and then come back out and do a couple coats later. Coffee. Oh, okay. Thank you. That is right. That's where mommy puts that. There you go. You can try some if you want. I had to wake him up from his nap. He slept for 3 hours, and honestly, I feel like he probably would have gave me another 20 minutes, and I just was worried that it would cause him to... No, thank you. I'll get you a cup to put that in, okay? Just a second, I'll get you one. Anyways, I was just worried it would affect his sleep tonight, but it was a great nap. Yeah. And he woke up in a good mood. I had to wake him up, and it took him a while to finally get up. But now you're going to eat some food, so I'm going to make lunch for him. I don't think Austin's going to be off anytime soon. He's going to have probably a late day, so it'll probably just be us today for most of the day, which is totally fine, but, you know, how it be. So, what was I going to... Oh, I was thinking about taking him on another walk, and we could go to the park, because it is actually nice out, and I want to take advantage of it. But we'll kind of see. I'm not sure. He kind of will tell me what we're gonna spend our time doing, huh? We went on a little walk to the park and it was so nice. It's like already getting so dark out, as you can tell. Like, it's dark in here and it's only 4:30, but Austin called me, he'll be home soon so I can like do some work once he gets home, which will be really nice. But Belle's been like such a joy to hang out with, honestly, today. I feel like I've been very productive and had like a really good day today, huh? Here he comes. Ah! I see you! What does Mama have? What is it? It's a cord cover. You want to help me? Come in here. So I'm going to put some cord covers over our TV because I got some on Amazon and I never used them. And yeah. Gotten a chance to show this on YouTube yet, but I've been wanting to get a Pickler, like Montessori, like jungle gym type deal for so long. Like, I wanted it for his first birthday and for his first Christmas, and I had actually ordered and paid for one, but it got canceled after shipping. The package got lost and I just kind of like forgot about it, plus I didn't really have the money after that. And they run anywhere from like $250 to $300, depending on what one you want to get. And this one I got used off of Facebook Marketplace, and it's rainbow. I don't know how that loaf of bread got there, but I would assume it has to do with this little person, peekaboo. But it's so great, and he really, really loves it. And on the other side of this board, peek. Peekaboo! I see you! Where's Belle? Peekaboo are little like rock climbing pieces. And so you can kind of use it as like just a slide. And then I know that there's like tons of different ways to use this and the play couch together. Hi! And the play couch that we have is the Sam's Club one. It's a lot cheaper than the name brand ones, and I think it's going on sale for like Black Friday, but I'm not sure. But I think between this and that, you can do a lot of different combinations. Hi, honey. So we'll have to look up on Pinterest some ideas. But we're just gonna play until Dad gets home and can help out with work. Hey, you're gonna knock that down. You don't wanna knock it down on you. And this is the time of day where I lose all energy, so I need to really rally because it's been such a great day so far. I did get our Wi-Fi thing figured out. Unfortunately, they're not gonna be able to fix it for another week, so I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I'm sure I will figure it out. I'll go to a friend's house or Starbucks or something, but that's just a lot easier said than done when you have a toddler with you, so we will see what happens with that.